joining us now. So clearly invaluable lessons come with being abroad, having face-to-face time, seeing the region that you were talking about from afar.
That's right. And I mean, look, let's be honest. He's only seen the opulence. He hasn't really met the people of the Arab world. But I think this is really his first introduction to Islam and Muslims. And, you know, usually he thinks of them as this group of people who are terrorists. Now he's listening to these leaders, starting to learn a little bit more that Islam is actually a faith, that these people have families, that they have hopes and dreams for their kids. And I think that's a really important education for this president. He's not someone who's traveled widely abroad. And when he does, he's really, you know, in one of his hotels.
Business dealings, but it's different as a diplomat now, representation
of the country.
He's
in his hotels or a conference room, and now he's getting exposed to this. So, you know, people made a lot about, you know, all those ceremonies and stuff, but I think it's really important for the president to learn that these are actual people with lives.
Has he also raised expectations then, perhaps the next time, whether it's to meet with these five other Middle Eastern Gulf nations next year annually, that in this case he almost brought sort of gifts, right? A commitment, business deals or a furtherance of existing business deals and military and arms, etc. Has he raised the bar?
I think what people are going to look for is a continuation of this. You know, this president is very transactional. So he came with this deal for the Saudis, the arms deal, you know, that gave him a little bit of leverage, but that's a lot of money and it's going to be carried over the term of his presidency. I don't think we're going to be able to see those kind of deals every year. So now he has to follow it up with what we call in diplomacy kind of tending the garden of continuing to show these leaders that the U.S. is there for them. And that's going to take the work of his team, I think.
It'll be a different technique, a different message as he embarks on Israel. He's not going to come bearing gifts. I mean, you know, tantamount to what we're seeing here in Saudi Arabia. So what is the expectation? I mean, can he look for the kind of measured successes that he's able to, you know, enjoy here?
Well, don't forget, he already gave Israel that gift, that big MOU of, you know, hundreds of billions of dollars of U.S. military aid over the next 10 years. So, you know, that was the gift. But I think that it's going to be tough for him in Israel after this Saudi arms deal. The Israelis are a little bit concerned that that will kind of lower their what they call qualitative military edge. They want to make sure that they can compete with all these Arab countries in their neighborhood to make sure that their military is strong enough. But I think that as the president becomes more educated with the Arab and Muslim world and sees, you know, not just the, you know, Muslim world, but the Israeli-Palestinian conflict from both sides, that's going to be a real education for him. And that's going to be difficult for Israel. Up until now, he's only seen this through the Israeli lens, dealing with Israel, dealing with the Jewish community. Now he's going to go to Bethlehem. He's going to see that big wall between Israel and the Palestinian territories that he's cited as, you know, a model for his wall along the border. And he's going to see how that impacts the Palestinians' lives. And I think as he learns more in the Arab world, in the Palestinian territories, about the conflict, about how it's affecting everybody's lives, it may not be so black and white for him. And, you know, he's always said he's the strong one for Israel. It might be a little bit more balanced.
And has said it might be easy. He would think that it would be easy to cut a deal.
It's not that easy.
So how will he, you know, measure a success? What will be a win for him once he were to leave Israel?
I think he wants to get out of Israel, you know, with an energy about a peace process that both leaders can say that they believe that this man is, that this leader is committed to peace and that they're on board. I mean, I think it's going to be, I think, the diciest visit for him because he's coming from this, you know, strong showing with the Arab leaders. He needs to show equal, you know, respect for Israel and that U.S. is a strong partner for Israel. I think he wants to get out of the Israeli and Palestinian territories without any real sticky going off script, any mess ups, and to just kind of stay focused on what he calls negotiating the ultimate deal. It's going to be, I think, the most interesting part of the trip, especially the trip to Bethlehem.
All right. All very fascinating. Thank you so much, Elise Labatt. Good to see you. All right. Coming up.